Hello children, good morning. In previous video, we had learned about subtraction of single digit number and two digit number. Simple subtractions. Now, we are going to learn about the regrouping of subtraction. Listen carefully. This is also a simple thing. So, please listen carefully. We'll start. If I'll write example, first example I'll write is 24 minus 8. See your children, this is the subtraction of two digit number with single digit number. So we need to mark the columns as tens and ones as we are adding two digit number here. So 24 minus 8, 8 is single digit number, so we have to write it in ones column. So see the columns carefully. 4 minus 8, 4 is smaller number and 8 is bigger number, so we can't subtract 8 from 4. So we need to borrow 1 from the tens column. For this, we need to draw a column here as leave a box here and write down numbers here. 24 minus 8. Okay? Now, we can't subtract 8 from 4. So, we need to borrow from tens column. When we are borrowing from tens column, we need to subtract 1 from the digit in tens column. Suppose here is 2. So if we'll subtract 1 from 2, 2 minus 1 is 1. So we need to put a line here and we need to write 1 here in tens column. Okay. So when we are borrowing 1 from tens column in ones column, at that time this 1 becomes 10. So here 10 plus 4. 10 plus 4 is 14. Now we need to subtract 8 from 14. So count from 8 to 14. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14 means 6. So we have to write 6 here in ones column. Now we have to subtract the digits from tens column. Now here is 1. 1 minus 0 is 1. So, the answer is 16. Now, one next example is 88 minus 9. See it carefully, children. Tens and ones column, mark first. Then leave a box here for the numbers to write the borrowing numbers. 88 minus 9. Okay. Now, here 9 is bigger number and 8 is smaller number. So, we can't subtract 9 from 8. So, we need to borrow from tens column. When we are borrowing, we are subtracting 1 from the given number in digit in tens column. So, 8 minus 1 is 7. Write down the 7 here in the box. Now, when we are borrowing 1 from tens column to the ones column, it is 10. 10 plus this 8. 10 plus 8 is 18. So, we can subtract 9 from 18. So, count from 9 to 18. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. This 9. So, write down this 9 in ones column. Okay. Now, go for tens column. Now, consider 7 here instead of 8. 7 minus no number means 0. 7 minus 0 is 7. So, the answer is 79. One more example we'll see. If I will write 54 minus 7, okay, again mark the columns as tens and ones, leave a box here, write down the numbers 54 minus 7, okay. Now, again, here 7 is a bigger number and 4 is a smaller number, so we can't subtract 7 from 4, so we need to borrow from tens column. So, instead of 5, cut this 5 and subtract 1 from 5 is 4. And when we are borrowing 1 from tens column to ones column, it will be 10. 10 plus 4. 10 plus 4 is 14. Now, we can subtract 7 from 14. So, count from 7 to 14. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. It is 5 plus 2, 7. So, write down 7 here in ones column. Go for tens column. So 4 minus no number is 0. 4 minus 0 is 4. So the answer is 47. Let's see some more examples. If I will write a number 67 minus 8. Okay. Write down the columns as tens and ones. Leave a box here. Write down the number 67 minus 8. Okay. Now here also, if you can see carefully, we can't subtract 8 from 7 as 7 is a smaller number. So we need to borrow again. So instead of 6, we have to write 5 here. Okay. And here, when we are borrowing 1 from 10's column to 1's column, it will be 10. So 10 plus 7 is 17. Okay. So we can subtract 8 from 17. So count from 8 to 17. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. It's 9. So write down 9 here. And here in 10's column, 5 minus no number is 0. So 5. So the answer is 59. Let's see one more example of 2-digit number to 2-digit number. If I write 51 minus 19. Okay. So again mark the columns as tens and ones. Leave a box here. Write down the numbers in a column 51 minus 19. This is the sign of subtraction. Okay. So again as a rule, first solve 12's column. So here is a 1 and here is 9. We can't subtract 9 from 1 as 1 is a smaller number. So we need to borrow again from 10's column. So the digit here is 5. So we need to cut it. Write down 4 instead of 5. And when we are borrowing from 10's column, it is? Yes, 10. Right. 10 plus 1. 10 plus 1 is 11. Now we can subtract 9 from 11. Right. So 9, 10 and 11. It's 2. So write down 2 in 1's column. Go for 10's column. Now here is 4 and 1. 4 minus 1 is 3. And the answer is 32. One more example, if I'll write 70 minus 38. Again we need to mark the columns as tens and ones. Write down the numbers here. 70 minus 38. Okay. Now, we can not subtract 8 from 0 as 0 is 0. So, we need to borrow again from 10's column. So, cut this. Write down 6 here. 7 minus 1 is 6. And when we are borrowing 1 from 10's column to 1's column, it is yes, 10 plus 0 is 10. Now we can subtract 8 from 10. So 9 and 10. After 8 count, 9, 10. So it's 2. So write down 2 here in 1's column. Go for 10's column. 6 minus 3. 6 minus 3 is 3. So the answer is 32.